Hit the subscribe button and activate the bell icon for more videos like this. I left my wife because I thought she was cheating. She became a heroin addict. I found out she never cheated. 6 disturbing confessions of Reddit, especially the last story will leave you stunned and sad. I discovered my dad's secret Facebook account. I was just in my dad's room helping him with his work on MS Word. We were halfway through and he said that he was going to go upstairs and get some refreshments. He left and I stayed in the room and decided to open my Facebook. Turns out someone had already been logged in and had a weird name unknown to me, and a profile pic of a cartoon guy. Anyways, being the little snoop I've always been, I clicked on the notifications and it redirected me to pictures to mainly African women, and I noticed that with this account, several comments were made on previous occasions about their bodies in sexual and lewd ways. Feeling a bit sick, I checked the account information, and lo and behold, this account was registered under my dad's email. I was about to log out when this woman messaged the account speaking of my dad in a really up close and personal manner. Read, sexting. I scrolled up to see the past history of their conversations and basically, my dad has been having cyber affairs with not just this woman, but with several. I physically felt sick and quickly shut the browser. He came back down and I just couldn't look the same at him anymore. I don't know what I should do. I haven't told anyone. It is my fault for going through his private information and I feel really bad. Ugh, this sucks so much. I want to impregnate my sister. Call me a pervert or whatever, I don't care. I'm a 21-year-old guy and my sister is 19. Ever since I can remember, I've been very attracted to her, and not in a normal brother-sister way. I've always had naughty fantasies about her and I've resisted my urges by masturbating to her pretty much every day. Luckily, she's not very careful and often walks around in a towel or less, not knowing how much it turns me on to see her body. Lately though, this hasn't been enough to satisfy me. No matter how much I masturbate, I still am insatiably horny for her and I know now that it's because I need to breed her. I will never be satisfied unless I pump her full of my fertile sperm and put a baby inside her. I want it more than anything and it's killing me that I can't do it. Is there anything I can do to deal with this dilemma? Anyone else gone through this? I think I've become a sociopath. It isn't officially diagnosed or anything but I feel no emotions or empathy. Growing up I was a people pleaser and cared too much about everyone around me. When I look back though, there were some signs that some things weren't right. When I turned 6 my dad became an alcoholic and started being abusive after my mom died. I quickly became depressed and acted out. I became aggressive and hypersexual and got in trouble at school a lot. I started bullying people and using them for whatever I wanted at the time. When my cat died when I was 8, I found its dead body and took a pencil and stabbed it in the eye and the stomach numerous times. I felt some sort of euphoria from seeing the blood. After that I became too interested in dissecting animals and would conduct science experiments on smaller animals. I would catch an animal, frog, toad, mouse, rat, fish, insects, really anything I could, keep it in containers and do science experiments on them that could be seen as torture. Just to name a few, I would see how long they would last without food, see how they would react to being set on fire, see how they would react if I suffocated them, see if they would cannibalize if left without food and only a dead body in a cage, etc. I always rationalized it in the name of science and since they were small animals I looked at them like NPCs. I would always gut them after they died and I kept the bones and skeletons of a few. I always saw it as a morbid curiosity of biology or something. I would use and manipulate people for sex at a very young age. They probably didn't even know what sex was and to be honest I didn't either. I just knew it felt good so I would make other kids do what I wanted and make them promise they won't tell. When I was in 6th grade my grandfather died, he was the only one who cared for me. I don't have any family who I was close to besides him. When he died I felt the most emotional pain I've ever felt, and for a while I became mad at the world and started getting in more trouble. I was stealing, getting in fights at school, I ran away from home a few times, etc. One night my father beat me so bad I almost killed him. When he fell asleep that night I took a knife and stood next to him and seriously debated stabbing him in the neck. The only reason I didn't was because I didn't want to go to jail. When I was in 8th grade a boy tried to rape me in the gym locker room so I beat him until he was bloody and I liked it way too much. After that I would have sexual fantasies involving boys being tortured and bloody, the closest I can think of is Jeffrey Dahmer type stuff. But after that happened I stopped wanting to socialize with anyone. Before this I was always popular in school, I didn't really care either way. I cut off everyone and stopped talking to everyone, even my own family. I would go to school then come home and stay in my room, distract myself, go to sleep then repeat. In freshman year of high school I got into semi-hard drugs, I started smoking, Xanax, cocaine, sleep meds and Adderall and drinking. I'm sure that messed with my brain even more. For the rest of high school I would use people for homework, sex, reputation etc. Until I dropped out my sophomore year. That year my dad and little sister died in a car crash, he was drunk and she was only 8 years old. To be honest I felt nothing at that point, my life was so bad I was just numb to everything and that made it worse. Since then I feel zero emotions or empathy, I can vaguely remember feeling emotions but I just feel nothing now. I think about killing myself every day and I honestly think I'll be dead by next year, it's better that way anyway. I have no family left, I have no career goals or future goals in general and I have no interest in relationships of any kind and to be honest I always wondered what happens when you die, so I'm just curious. I've obviously never told anyone any of this and never will, except for Reddit now I guess. Congrats if you read this all the way. I did something really weird that you may consider disgusting and I want to vomit when I think about it. A few months ago I was watching regular porn and I got really horny thinking about this one girl I liked. And I got this great at the time, idea that I'm gonna smell my mom's dirty panties and pretends like it's the girl's panties. I was really horny so I went to get the dirty panties and smelled them and instantly became horny as hell. So I put them on my face and lie down and started masturbating and thinking about the girl, I noticed there was discharge on it and I licked it and still I was thinking about the girl. Then when I was done I just threw the panties away and instantly wanted to vomit thinking that it was my mom's and not the girl's. I was so disgusted and started to shake and immediately started washing my mouth and my teeth. I took a shower and started to clean my mouth and face with everything I could find. I was so disgusted and even now I feel like vomiting when I think about it. I don't have any sexual thoughts of my mom even though my friends say she is a hot MILF. I don't find her that sexy and I don't watch and stepson porn either. I was just horny and the whole time thinking about the girl. I am ashamed and disgusted. I am a female sex addict who has never desired marriage, but now it's what I want because I want a steady sex partner for the rest of my life. I hate my addiction. I'm 25 and I've had sex with somewhere between 80 to 100 men. I lost count a few years ago. Granted I was not penetrated by all these men. Maybe 30 were just oral sex, giving or receiving, but that still leaves a large number. Many of them have been unprotected and I do have HPV. I am HIV negative since the last time I checked and none of the guys I've been with have been sketchy. Also, I've never actually had a guy come inside of me. I'm actually very choosy about the guys I have sex with because I'm afraid of HIV and could never live with that. It has made me hate myself for a long time. I don't know why I do what I do. A lot of it has to do with alcohol. I tried to replace sex with masturbation, but it only makes it worse. The only thing I can do to stop is stay away from alcohol and men. If I feel an urge I fight back the need to masturbate until I can no longer take it. I try not to watch or read porn anymore, but I know that masturbating is far safer than acting out. I've never wanted marriage, but I believe it will be what is best for me. From now on I want to stay celibate until I find the right person. I want someone I can be honest with about my past. Maybe he will be a former sex addict as well. I just want to be normal, but I have to accept this as my life. I have thought about suicide many, many times, but I know that would never be the answer. I left my wife because I thought she was cheating, she became a heroin addict. I found out she never cheated. Disclaimer, I have always been an emotional and stupid of a person. I wish I could say this was out of the norm. I've been in therapy since I was 11 years old. I met my wife in 2005 in a nightclub in Lower Manhattan, and she was an amazing person and we connected right away. We dated, then got married in 2007. I was 23, she was 25, but we were in love and to us it didn't really matter. We actually had a good marriage, and I loved her, and she loved me. I was shocked at how much we got along, for so many years. Meanwhile most people in relationships started to hate me after like 3 months. She still adored me after 7 years. But leave it up to me to screw that up completely. In 2014, I had suspicions she was cheating on me. Not strong suspicions, but she had a coworker who she was friends with who was, well, really attractive. I just thought, why be friends with this guy? She didn't often make friends with her coworkers, why this guy specifically? Because he was hot? She was secretive about him, which made me way more suspicious. I remember one day she told me that she had a secret about him which she would eventually tell me. I probably should have listened and understood what she said more, the hints she were dropping seem really obvious in retrospect. I didn't get any of her hints. For a bit, she got defensive over her phone. That was when I sort of began really suspecting things. One day I checked her phone and all I saw was him texting her saying he really needs to speak to her, right now. Like a bunch of texts. Also texts about sort of inappropriate sex stuff. But it was really the I need to see you now texts which threw me off. I didn't even confront her. That's the worst part. I just left, and went to New Mexico to go stay with my parents. I was so sure she cheated on me, nothing could convince me otherwise. I was so hurt that I became suicidal for a tiny bit, then I went to therapy and got better. But I blocked her in every possible way I could. She had no idea why I left. My therapist kept telling me to contact her, I never listened. I actually lied to my therapist and said I did. There were some times where she called my parents and I talked to her and just said that I knew she was cheating, and that I couldn't be with her and that was that and then I just hung up. It was too horrible and emotional and I just wanted to put it all behind me somehow. I wanted to act as if it never happened. I didn't have the balls to deal with it. I didn't file divorce papers at that time. I never explained anything further than that, I just hung up. In 2015, I painfully reconnected with her. I never told her why I left. I felt horrible, but I also felt angry at her for cheating. I never wanted to know who she cheated on me with, or what the situation was, I just wanted her out of my life. But when I finally connected with her, I just found an entirely new person. She was in and out of rehab, she was a pill addict. She said it started after I had left her, that she had a lot of pills left over from a surgery she had. She had a knee surgery in 2013, and started taking them a lot to deal with the pain of me leaving her. Then she connected with her friend who started selling pills to her. Anyways, after a bit more of talking with her online over quite a few weeks, I eventually told her the situation as to why I thought she cheated. It was sort of this unspoken thing beforehand, I told her I didn't want her to bring it up. Then I just asked her, straight up. And she told me, that was her coworker, and he was gay. She hung out with him a lot, and he would often call her and text her to come over so they could talk about his problems. I checked his Facebook, he came out officially as gay in 2014, before that he was in the closet. Also, the inappropriate sex stuff they were talking about suddenly made so much sense. They were comparing the way women and men have sex to the way men have sex with men. But it didn't seem obvious by the texts I read, it just kind of sounded like they were planning to do anal with each other. In retrospect it seems painfully obvious, but at the time it wasn't. I just wish I didn't freak out and leave. I think if I even mentioned his name, it would have clicked for her, and she would have told me it was just a misunderstanding. But she had zero idea why I suspected her of cheating. I left my wife, never spoke to her again, and went halfway across the country over a misspoken series of texts that I read, because I was a sneaky bastard and was too emotional to even ask my wife what the problem was. I just left. I never asked her to clarify anything. She would go on to become a heroin addict from a pill addict. She posts sometimes about how she is 3 weeks sober. But it's never longer than that. I am basically an alcoholic and live near my parents in Albuquerque. I have zero interest in finding a girlfriend, instead I just have a bunch of meaningless one-night stands when I go out on weekends. I am almost always hammered and coked or Adderall'd up when I go out on weekends. I sort of have friends, but not really, they're just a bunch of alcoholics and party people in the area who I link up with on weekends. I can't be away from my parents now, they're the only people I enjoy being around. I am just an emotionally fragile mess who feels like they completely ruined someone's life over something so stupid. I know it sounds stupid but for the past few years my parents are the only friends I have and the only people I really see besides the people at my job and the women I sleep with, who I never make connections with. I cannot help but think I will literally never get over this. The fact that I ruined her life over this. I go to therapy, and it helps but not enough. I still sometimes talk to her. We officially got divorced, nothing split, in 2017. She is a heroin addict and I am horribly depressed so we have some relations, but I can't help but think that I ruined her life far, far more than I ruined mine. And the worst part is? The only reason I am in pain is because I ruined her life. I binge-watched all of BoJack Horseman and connected with his character, a lot. I feel like he inspired me to make this post. Thanks for listening to hit the subscribe button and activate the notification bell for more videos. Let us know in the comments what you think about these stories. Hit the subscribe button and activate the bell icon for more videos like this.